Welcome back, gang. This is Bros and Shows. I'm Anthony.
I'm Hunter.
And today we're on episode 13, and we're coming off of a pretty awesome episode on Clear, which is really based around Rick, Michonne, Carl, and Morgan.
Yes. Good job. You remember the
names. Yeah.
Let's go.
It really broke my heart to see how Morgan ended up, and you know, the parallels between Rick and him were pretty obvious. You know, if given the same situation, that could have happened to Rick.
100%. It could have been. That could have just as easily been Rick's fate as it was for Morgan. You know, I mean, he's halfway there. He lost his wife now. You know, so he really has to be protective of Carl because, I mean, he sees now firsthand the reminder of what this world is. Not as if he doesn't need another reminder, but, like, he got one anyways. Yeah, that was nuts.
And then just the parallel between Carl and then Morgan's son, where Morgan's son couldn't shoot the mom, but Carl had, he understood.
He had to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that ultimately just, everything. From Rick not stopping the guy in the prison like we talked about that led to that whole incident to Morgan not killing his wife when he had the chance laid into that incident.
It's all about the repercussions of the decisions you make.
Yeah.
Every decision you make, no matter how seemingly small, can have gigantic repercussions.
Yeah.
So it just shows you that no half measures can be taken.
Not in this world, it seems like, right?
You have any predictions for how this fight's going to go with the governor?
I just don't feel like their side, like Rick's team's not going to walk away with this without a couple of deaths. Just because the scale of the fight's going to be huge.
Yeah.
Then on top of that, two factions heavily armed fighting each other. Then you got the zombies or the walkers out and about. And that's just going to probably create a whole mess. And knowing the governor, he's probably going to bring in walkers to create a distraction or chaos like he did when he first hit the prison.
Yeah. I mean, he's definitely... There's no Geneva Convention anymore, right?
No.
So any tactical warfare that you can come up with is fair game.
Yeah.
Whatever you can think of. I do think that if we didn't go on that side quest to find supplies, everyone would have died in the prison.
Oh, yeah.
Because we just came home with an arsenal.
Mm-hmm.
Morgan went back to the police station because when they went there originally with Carl in the beginning, they didn't have the manpower or the capability to take all those guns.
Yeah.
But when Morgan came back alone after Dwayne had died, he had all the time in the world and he didn't really care about his own death. So he's just like, whatever, I'll clear this whole fucking thing out. I'll take all these guns. I'll set up my place. I'll clear. And the fact that we have every single weapon that was in that police station now is pretty crazy.
Yeah.
Where they got the grenades, I don't know.
Yeah, that's
because there's not a stash of grenades in a small town police department. I promise you that. Maybe he looted them from like a nearby army base. Maybe,
I would have to.
Maybe he went to Fort Benning.
Yeah.
And who knows? That's what I'm going to just say he did.
Who knows? Oh, man.
You want to get into episode 13?
Yes, I do. I
Arrow on the doorstep.
Let's do it.
Cool. I did a poll for the season 3 MVP on the channel.
Mm-hmm.
So far, Daryl's winning. Personally, I gave it to Herschel.
Yeah, Herschel.
I voted for Herschel. Sick vest, dude.
Mm-hmm.
Is this like another flash forward like we did in that one Rick Shane episode? Because we never even saw them get back with the guns. That's pretty slick.
Definitely have a gun, but I'd have something for melee weapon as well.
That is a melee weapon.
yeah, I guess, yeah. Oh, no way! No, what's about to go down? Are they
I was waiting for you to see this reveal.
They're about to have just like a talk first? So? I would have shot him in the face right there.
We have a lot to talk about.
Such a good cold open. Would you have just shot him?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. You take their leadership away like him, that whole community would fall apart.
Or Andrea would take over leading it and then they'd be peace peaceful. Yeah. She'd be like, dude, they're just prisoners. There's like seven of them. They're not a threat.
Yeah.
You attacked us. Makes things pretty clear. I was trying to make things clear. I could have killed you all. I didn't. I'm going to remove my weapon. Show that I mean to negotiate in good faith. I'd like you to do the same. No trouble. Now you.
Of course.
I see!
What the hell's Milton doing here?
Right? What's he gonna do?
The hell? Why's your boy already in there?
He's here?
Yep.
What's going on?
Nothing. Brandon isn't much for small talk.
We can solve this. That's why I asked you to come here.
I know what you've done. I heard about the raids, the heads, Maggie. Merle did that. No. You know what I'm talking about.
You know all about me, and I know all about you. I don't care about any of that. We're here to move forward.
Maybe I should join SAT.
The governor thought it best if he and Rick spoke privately.
Andrea's already in there.
Who are you?
Milton Mammoth.
Great. He brought his butler.
Where's the rest of his dudes, though? I feel like he's got people in the tree line.
He hasn't, you know, he doesn't play fair.
What we should be doing is loading some of this firepower in a truck and paying a visit to the governor.
He's not wrong.
Yeah. We know where he is right now.
You suggesting so that we just go in and kill him?
Yeah, I am.
A thousand things could go wrong.
And they will.
My dad can take care of himself.
Sorry, son, but your dad's head could be on a pike real soon.
There's no reason.
Get to it.
Woodbury takes west of the river. Prison takes east. No one crosses, no one trades.
Absolutely not.
What the hell am I doing here? You told me.
Told him what?
You told me he was willing to talk.
I am. But the truth is, Rick, she's in no position to make such an offer anyway. I'm here for one thing only. Your surrender.
Oh, you want surrender? Come get it. You think we hit Woodbury heavy last time?
Would you step outside?
What?
Rick and I, we got a lot to talk about.
I'm not leaving.
I came to talk to him.
The Andrea disrespect just continues. She has just been...
I mean, she's trying to take the high road.
Dude, she's right. You know, like, she is trying to do right, but she doesn't realize who the governor is still.
Yeah.
I do feel bad for her. She gets shit on by everyone at every turn. Something about these two on screen together, though. It's just good.
Yeah.
Wasn't Merle your lieutenant?
He was helpful, yeah.
But you knew he was erratic. You blame him for scooping up Glenn and Maggie in the first place?
Exactly. I was trying to sort it out when you attacked.
So it was his fault.
He's a wild card, but he's effective. He gets the dirty jobs done.
Oof. I here we go.
That later. You're the town drunk who knocked over my fence or ripped up my yard. Nothing more.
Andrew told me about your baby. Be your partners.
Damn, Andrea, you're spilling all the secrets.
I admire that. Restitution for your own lack of insight.
Oof.
For failing to see the devil beside you.
Oh,
I see him all right.
There's no reason not to use the time we have together. Explore the issues ourselves.
I said to sit tight and shut up.
You mean the governor?
They're gonna work it out, and nobody wants another battle.
Exactly, call it a battle.
I would call it a battle, and I did. I recorded it. be a part of our history.
That makes sense.
I've got dozens of interviews.
I don't trust you. I understand what he's saying.
Ooh. Daryl wins. How you like that, Martinez?
For menthols.
Beggars can't really be choosers.
Douchebag.
This is a joke, right? Ain't gonna work anything out. I'm sure they'll do their little dance tomorrow, next day. They'll give the word.
So, you cut off your leg to keep the infection from spreading. Interesting. How long after the initial bite?
Minutes.
Immediately.
You didn't bleed out?
We have good people.
May I see it?
At least buy me a drink first.
I love Herschel.
Yeah.
You've moved into our backyard, you've shot up Main Street. If I let that threat persist, I look weak and the whole thing crumbles.
Well, that's your problem, your choice.
Now, isn't that why we're here?
I was at work one day, taking shit from a boss half my age and an IQ even lower. And the phone rang. My wife had been in an accident.
Sorry, Mr. Blake, we did everything we could. God. It's just an accident, no one's fault.
She'd left a voicemail asking me to call her, but I hadn't had a chance yet. What did she want?
He's like, I'm so good at this. Mm-hmm. I'm so good at manipulating people's
right.
emotions.
Such a piece of shit.
Yeah, that's a good haul. Holy shit.
Hey, you're not going. I don't need permission. Let me go. Let me go.
The voice of reason right here.
Always, right?
How's it going in there?
They kicked me out. What happened with Maggie?
Oof.
She's a
yeah.
sick man.
She has no idea about that, huh?
You know, the truth is I didn't want any of this. They chose me because there was nobody else around. I know you got guns. That was quite a stash you bought back.
How does he know about that?
Now, my people, they're not combat tested like
probably because they're keeping an eye on him.
I've got more of them. You have something that I want. I want Michonne.
Ah, there it is, yeah.
Turn her over and this all goes away.
I don't believe him.
You've obviously got big plans. You're the guy who's gonna lick this thing. Bring us back from the brink. So why waste your time on a two-bit vendetta? I give you Michonne. How do I know you'll keep your word?
I told you I don't care about you.
He's full of shit.
So full of shit. He'll be back with a private assassination squad just for you.
Yep. You think about it. He's gonna take out one of your strongest fighters.
Who are you gonna go back with? Every time she makes the wrong choice, dude.
She's the only one that can kill him in his sleep.
way to avoid a slaughter.
That is a slaughter.
Mm-hmm.
That is a slaughter.
All right, all right, Milton.
We'll have to eliminate Rick sooner or later.
This is... See, you're seeing who he really is, yep, huh?
100%. Especially after his talk with Herschel.
Yeah.
He knows that they're not bad people.
Wants to prison.
Oh, so they're both manipulating now.
We're going to war.
Woo! But I like how he didn't bring up the whole Michonne thing, because it wasn't even in his mind.
Not even in his mind.
Yeah. Merrill was right. Should have just taken the chance right there.
Yep.
The group's taking it as well as can be expected. Merrill and Michonne are convinced we should hit first. We're in this together. So if we stay and fight, so be it.
He gave me a choice.
Oh, he's telling him the truth.
What does he want?
Michonne.
He'll kill her.
And then kill us anyway.
Yep. He knows him.
Yeah.
He knows him. He's so fucking smart, dude.
Yep.
Why didn't you tell them?
They need to be scared.
True.
They are.
Good.
Glenn, Maggie. If she hadn't come here, we never would have known they were taken.
So true.
Yeah.
They earned their place.
They would just be gone.
Yeah. I'm hoping you can talk me out of it.
What do you think about that?
So I can definitely see the moral dilemma from both standpoints, because she, without her, your daughter already would have been dead.
Yeah, and you would have no idea why. And
yeah.
Glenn, too. They would just be, you would just assume they were killed by walkers on the run.
Yeah.
You know?
But at the same time, when you bring your kids involved, then, like, I understand that aspect, too. Like, do you take the chance if there is a way to get out of this, like, especially because you got an infant and a young son, even though Carl is, you know, obviously pretty capable and he's matured a lot since the very first season when we saw him, but still, they're your kids.
Yeah, but let's say his gut is right, and if he hands over Michonne and then the governor comes to kill them anyways, all he's done is take away one fighter.
Yep.
That he has to defend himself.
Absolutely.
So, I think that handing over Michonne...
And you have two people who've seen what he's like. One person
exactly.
Who's done missions for him.
Thank you.
Telling you, like, hey.
This dude, is what he's about.
Yeah, it's like, this is all part of a ploy. Like, you should, I hope he brings it up to the team. And then, like, this is where Merrill will shine the most. Is
right.
Like, you guys, I have been telling you, this guy's a piece of shit. Like,
right.
he literally is going to betray you guys right when he gets the chance and kill everybody.
Well, Herschel called him the black sheep. And that's. And maybe it's like a self-fulfilling prophecy, but it's definitely come to fruition because he's 100% right. Like, they should have gone and killed the governor right then and there. All they had to do was kill the governor, Martinez, and Milton, and then it was over.
It would have fallen apart.
Exactly.
The leadership would have fallen apart.
But because Merle's the black sheep, nobody really listens to what he's saying. Nobody's really taking his advice, even though he's 100% right. And Michonne is kind of trying to toe that line because she knows everything that Merle knows. She knows that they killed those army guys because she's not stupid. She
yeah.
inspected the trucks and stuff, and she knows what he's about. She saw the heads firsthand. So she's trying to kind of toe that line of, okay, I need to, like, fit in with this group and not seem like a bloodthirsty killer who wants to go kill them, but at the same time inform them of what kind of man he really is.
Yeah.
You know, so she's not going full Merle, but I agree with Merle 100%. I
mean, yeah.
He's right. They should have gone and killed him.
Absolutely.
It's kind of a mess, honestly, dude. Like, because he can't be trusted, right? Nothing he does so far has showed anything other than I will betray you.
Yeah.
I will lie to you, I will manipulate you, and I will keep you in the dark, you know?
Yeah, he's got to go. He's the worst, especially in this world where it's already just terrible as it is. And then you're have this dude who's just a master manipulator. And I like how everyone's kind of catch on now. Like, Milton, you know, he's catching on, like, just based off that little conversation with Herschel, seeing that they're not bad people, like you said. And then talking to him, and he's just basically, what about your plan, you said? He's like, oh.
That was a lie.
Yeah, he's just like, oh, you're starting to see who this dude is, huh?
I like how he was like, this is the only way to avoid a slaughter. And Milton was actually like, that is a slaughter. What are you talking about? You're going to kill all of them?
Like, yeah. Like, the kids, too? Like, that's... Yeah. That's where I, like, if you have any somewhat of moral compass, you should be like, no, dude. You're going to go kill children on top of it?
I also think that this show is great at humanizing every character, even the villains, because when the governor was talking about his wife and how he was at work and he got a phone call saying that she was dead after he missed the phone call from her and, like, probably playing out that guilt, like, what if I answered the phone? You know, would that have changed things? And blah, blah, blah. Like, that humanizes him. It makes you feel for him and sympathize with him, but...
He uses it to manipulate.
Exactly. And you can tell when the governor talks because the actor, and I don't remember, I don't know exactly his name. I have to look it up. I think it's David something. The way he utilizes a smile is unlike any actor I've ever seen in my entire life. He, just having a simple conversation, will throw in these weird, like, full teeth smiles.
Yeah.
And he's just so good at disarming you while still coming across as totally threatening.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's absolutely crazy. I just love seeing it. But I also like that Rick kind of wasn't taking any chances still. You know, he's like, I put my gun away. And Rick's like, okay, good for you. I'm putting mine right here and keeping it on me. Like, I'm not an idiot. And sure enough, he had a gun behind the table.
Yep.
Just shows everything the governor does, there's something behind the scenes.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like that was a perfect metaphor for, like, the gun behind the table. It's perfect metaphor for the governor. Always something else that he's not telling you, you know? You have any predictions? I think we have two episodes left, 14, 15, and 16.
It's going to be an all-out war. I mean, that's what I'm predicting. I'm predicting either one of the... It's not like they're going to meet in open battlefield. Like, they're going to be like, all right, we're going to meet here for battle. It's going to be someone's going to hit each other first, right, kind of thing. And that's the smartest way of doing it. Like, within those 2 days, if they're really trying to get it done, you do it before the meeting when they're still, like, preparing and everything.
Like, ambush.
Yep.
Yeah. Do you think that by the end of season 3, everything's going to be settled? Like, with Woodbury?
I don't know. I really don't know at this point. Like, I definitely see if everyone finds out what kind of person the governor really is, that whole community will fall apart. Just because... You have that. At that point, you realize you have this very manipulative leader, and everything is just kind of surface at the point. Like, everything seems nice, but in reality, there's a lot of dark and scheming things happening.
Yeah, he's got, like, his 10 people on the inside that kind of, like, know his dirty work, but are, I guess, subscribed to the same exact way of thinking that he is, that, like... You need people behind the scenes to take care of the dirty work and let the people have their carefree existence, right? I think that they're drinking the Kool-Aid 100%. And you're right. I think that if the normal people of the town found out what was going on, they would probably not want to be there. I mean, we already saw it when the governor kind of had his moment after Michonne stabbed his eye and he comes out and shoots the guy on the ground after being bit. Everyone's trying to leave. Everyone was like, let us out. And so I think that it wouldn't take much for them to be like, no, we're done.
Yeah.
We're leaving. But at the same time, if the governor is coming back and telling all the people that the people at the prison are well-armed, a lot of numbers, fighting-age males, like, if they lied to them and they believe all this propaganda, they're going to be like, okay, we have to go take care of them.
And then you got the group that came from the prison meeting Rick when he had his mental, and that only fuels the fire.
Dude, it's a perfect storm.
Yeah.
Because you have these people that were there that can be like, yeah, he's crazy. But at the same time, they also know that there's only like 8 of them, and some of them are women and children, and it's just like, it's just not going to add up.
Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like it's a lot to juggle with all his lies.
Mm-hmm.
But fear is the best motivator.
Oh, right? Yeah.
So all you have to do is get a town full of people scared, and you can pretty much get them to do whatever you want them to do. Yeah.
We'll see what happens.
Give me a new tier list. Give me top 2, bottom 2.
Top 2 hated.
Okay.
The governor for sure.
So bottom two.
Oh yeah, bottom two.
Bottom two would be the governor and.
And then I would have to say, just Andrea still, and not it just the indecisiveness in seeing patterns at this point, mm-hmm. and the story's not adding up, and you not trying to make, like, I don't know. If I were her, I'd have been like, I'm going with them. See ya.
Yeah, no, I 100% agree. I think that it's so hard to, like, get on the side of Andrea because I want to so bad. Because she wants...
Her intentions are pure.
Her intentions are so pure, and she's trying to do the right thing, and I do think she's a good person, but she's just so bad at, like, reading people mm-hmm. and understanding that the governor is a bad man, and she needs to... stop living in La La Land where we can all just get along. And I love her intentions. They're pure. But she's lost the plot, I think. I don't think she's my bottom two characters, though. I think for me, it's the governor, obviously. He's just a total piece of crap. And I'm not really sure I have another bottom one right now because even Martinez and Milton during their conversation,
they just showing
they're good people, you know, deep down, and they just want to, you know, live like anybody else. So I don't really have a second bottom person, but for my top two, it's got to be Herschel number one and Rick number two, just because...
Herschel, for sure, is number one for me because he's the glue.
Yeah.
And then, to be honest, Michonne definitely shined with mm-hmm. these last few episodes. And then her, like you said, she's like toting the line right now where she's ready to go, but she's not trying to push the situation, you know? Because I think she's more aware than Meryl is. It's like, there's children here. There's people who don't really have combat experience. They're not trying to look for that.
Right.
So if we can go a different route, like, let's see what Rick can do. But if we got to fight, well, I'm ready to fight.
She also doesn't want, like, the blood on her hands.
Yeah.
When Meryl wanted to go and, you know, kill the governor right then, she's like, go alone. Because if you get people killed, it's on you.
Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah. All right, well, we'll see you guys in episode 14 called Prey. I'm Hunter.
I'm Anthony.
This is Bros and Chubs. Like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.
Peace.
Come again. Come right now.